What's up, guys, and welcome back. I'm Mike. Today we are talking about the big debate, live bait versus artificial. We are right in the middle of summer, which means that we're also in the middle of croaker season. A lot of people are out there throwing croaker or live shrimp, a lot of live bait users right now throwing all kinds of live bait. And if that's you, if you like to throw croaker, if you like to fish with croaker, by all means, go fish with croaker. Do what makes you happy. I will never tell somebody the way they should or shouldn't be fishing. But today, I am going to give you five reasons why you might want to make that change over to artificial. All right, so recently I went on a few fishing trips with some friends, and they wanted to throw live croaker, and well, I threw croaker right next to them. It was, we had some good days and we had some bad days. We had, you know, trips that we went out and caught a bunch of trout really, really quickly, and then I had some days where we were grinding all day long, just like, you know, I would with artificials. You have your good and your bad. But after those two trips, I sat back and I thought about the advantages and the disadvantages to live and artificial, and I just couldn't come up with a true advantage to throwing live bait or throwing croaker over artificial. And I'm gonna tell you five reasons why. All right, number five, which is probably the most significant reason, and that is cost. There's no way around it. It is more expensive to use live bait than it is artificial. I recently went out with some friends and they wanted to use croaker. They ended up buying 8 dozen croaker, which was, well, it was over $100 for one day. One day of fishing was over $100 just in bait. Now, if you fish like I do, once, twice a week, sometimes even more, well, that's $400, $500, $800, $1,000 in a single month just on bait. Now, I know you can get a cast net and you can go out and you can catch your own bait, but that's not the only cost. See, you have to have a live well, and you have to have oxygen and bubblers to keep your live bait well alive. So there's more cost involved in that. You know, when it comes to artificial, well, you buy some lures, you buy some soft plastics. A pack of lures is, you know, $5, $6, $8, and they'll last you well over a day most of the time. Now, I know there are some lures that are, you know, $10, $15, $20 for one lure. But you can use them over again most of the time. I have lures. I have some corkies that are, you know, $15. I've had those for 4, 5, 6 years. Still using them. Still catching fish on them. I've caught hundreds of fish on the same lure. No extra cost. The only cost in that is that occasionally I have to change out the hooks on them. But still cheaper. Way cheaper. And I can use them forever. I actually have soft plastic packages. That I've had, you know, just as long, 4 and 5 years, and I haven't gone through them. And even if you have a huge collection of soft plastics like I do, and different lures and topwaters and all of that stuff, well, you're buying them little at a time, and, you know, you can keep reusing them. And, you know, when you buy a package of, you know, 6 soft plastics and you run through them, you know, in a month, well, you go and you spend another $6 and you get another package. It's just cheaper. It's all around cheaper. There's no way that live bait will ever be cheaper than artificial. All right, number four is I don't want to have to rely on live bait to catch fish. Unfortunately, bait is seasonal. So, you know, in the spring and summer, you can get a lot of that croaker. The bait shops are going to be stocked full of croaker. You can go and get that. But when that season ends in the fall and winter, yeah, there's just not enough bait fish anymore to keep those places stocked, and so they generally don't even carry them. At that point, you can switch over to shrimp or do something else. But a lot of those guys that are throwing that in the spring and summer, when it comes to fall and winter, they switch over to artificial anyway. So, now you're buying both. It's just not worth it to do that. But you know what's not seasonal, and that's artificial bait. It doesn't matter what you're using, whether it's topwaters, you're using paddle tails, soft plastics, twitch baits, corkies, doesn't matter. You can use it year round. There is no season for it, and you can catch fish all year long. If you look at the guys that are throwing artificial year-round weather, you know, the good ones are catching fish all the time. It doesn't matter. The only thing that you really have to worry about is color, the type of bait, and there is no season for artificial bait. You can use it whenever, all year, and catch fish. All right, number three, you're just going to catch better fish on artificial. And the biggest reason why is because you know what feeds on live bait, on shrimp, and on croaker? Everything. Everything will hit that. So if you're somebody that's targeting redfish, if you're targeting trout, if you're targeting flounder, well, chances are you're gonna catch a lot of other fish that you don't want. You're gonna catch those hardhead catfish and the gaff tops and black drum and sheep's head and maybe a lot of fish that you just don't wanna catch. And if you're using artificial, well, you're minimizing that. Now, I have caught some catfish on artificial, and I've caught black drum, and I've caught, you know, a lot of that. You're just minimizing it. It's a lot less, and generally, you're only going to catch those predator fish, those redfish and the trout and flounder. That's what is going to hit artificial way more often than the trash fish that you don't want. Number two, you will become a better fisherman using artificial. Unlike live bait, where you just kind of throw it out there and you're really relying on the bait that you're using to determine, those fish biting. With artificial, you are forced to learn a lot more about those fish. You're forced to learn to understand the characteristics and the actions of those fish and what they like, the speed in which you have to retrieve your lures, the colors that you use, the type of baits, you know, where in the water column. There's a lot to be learned when you're using artificial. In fact, if you were to take two fishermen and put them side by side out in the water using the exact same setups, the same lures, chances are one of them is going to outfish the other. And a lot of times it has to do with how they're retrieving that or what they're doing, and really controlling that lure. And over time, you start to put those pieces together and, you know, put all the puzzle pieces and you start to figure out, okay, you know, I need to start moving my bait this way or faster or slower. I start twitching it a little bit different. And once you get enough of that together, you really gain that experience where you understand these fish. You understand their actions. You understand the characteristics, what makes them bite, you know, what keeps them from biting. And over time, you have so many puzzle pieces that you can make a lot of changes on the fly. And you can, you can be using something and then immediately switch over to another lure because of, you know, something that's going on in the water. And you start learning things like water clarity and what colors that you need to use. There's just a lot to be learned when you're using artificial, and it really, really helps you understand fish. All right, and the number one reason to switch to artificial is, well, it's just a lot more fun to catch a fish on artificial than it is on live bait. There's something to be said about going and picking your lures and picking, you know, the colors and the type of lure and getting out there and really figuring out how to work that lure and then a fish slam it. It is, there's nothing like it. It's extremely exciting. Now, I've heard people say all the time, there's just nothing like that thump of a croaker or live bait. But it doesn't compare. It doesn't compare to, you know, the same size fish hitting a corky or hitting a topwater and, you know, watching that topwater fly out of the water and the fish chase it and they just slam it. Not only that, but you've already got tension on the line because you're moving the lure through the water. And so a lot of times those fish have to swim faster to catch up. And when they hit it hard. I mean, I've had fish almost pull a rod out of my hand because they hit it so hard. There's nothing like it. It doesn't compare. I've done both. I've done both many, many times. And it is way more exciting to catch those fish on an artificial lure than it is on live bait. Every single time they hit it like that, it blows my mind. That excitement and that adrenaline that you get instantly is just, it's something special. It is just way, way more fun to put all of those puzzle pieces together and really, really figure it out, and it just works. It's exciting, and it's just a ton of fun. All right, guys, well, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you haven't made the switch to artificial, give it a shot. Go try it out. And you know what? If it's not for you and you would prefer to go and use live bait and use croaker, by all means, go do it. Go out there, catch fish, have fun the way that you want to. That's what it's all about. Just enjoy yourself. I hope you guys have tons and tons of fish in your future. Full limits to all of you. I appreciate you guys for watching. Thank you so much. If you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button, like the video, comment below, tell me what you think, and we'll see you next time.